Let us praise the Lord another time. Amen. Lift up his name and give him thanks, because God alone is worthy to be praised. And this morning, I just want to honor him because of his goodness and his mercies towards me. I woke up this morning singing this song, "The Savior is Coming." And as we're about to open the service, I just want to welcome everyone here and everyone that is online. We just want to thank God for all of you. I know for some of you, it may well be a time of sacrifice, but the Lord desires us to be in his presence. And that is an amazing thing. Praise the Lord. God wants us to come and to give him thanks. And as we know, when we come into the sanctuary of the Lord, we bring our sacrifices, praises, and thanksgiving unto him. And so, beloved ones, I greet you in the mighty name of Jesus. And to all our officers that are here and online, we just give God thanks. Bless the name of Jesus. And at this moment, we just stand and we bow our heads in prayer in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you, God, for your mercies which you have poured out upon all mankind. You send the rain upon the just and the unjust. Your desire, Lord God, is that everyone would come unto repentance and be saved. And so you sacrificed your life, Father, in the name of Jesus, that we should live and not die. And this morning we come before your presence, O God, and we lift up your name in praises, with thanksgiving, in adoration, and in worship. And we pray today, God, that you will bless each and every one of us that have come into your presence. We pray, Lord Jesus, my God, as we stand up for the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. As we live for you, then we are also prepared to die for you. And so, eternal Father, we ask your divine blessings upon this service today. We pray, Lord, that you touch the hearts and the souls of all that will hear this broadcast and are sitting in the service. We pray today that your will be done in the mighty name of Jesus, as we say thank you now in Jesus' name. Amen. Bless the Lord Jesus. And today, I just want to briefly say something that the Lord has placed in my spirit. Bless the Lord Jesus. The song that we just, or the chorus we just sang, "The Savior is Coming," it's for us to always keep in mind something the Lord has impressed on me to speak to the church, and just simply to say we must always bear in mind that the Savior is coming again. He's coming with power, and he's coming to reign. Hallelujah. The little flock can rejoice and give God glory. Praise the Lord. Another thing I must say to you, the Lord impressed on my spirit for every one of you, those online, those who are here in the sanctuary, the Lord is saying to us, we must gather our families. Gather our families. And bring them into the house of the Lord. Bring them in the presence of God. Bring them to the Lord. The Savior is coming, beloved ones. So let us hold firm, stay strong, despite what we see going on in the world today. God's got his eye on you. God is watching over you. Hallelujah. He's keeping you. He's providing for you. He's making a way for you. Don't forget. The Savior is coming. Bless the Lord Jesus. Keep your mind, stay on him. As I now hand over to the host for today, missionary Sadie Copeland, in the name of the Lord Jesus. God bless you.
Shall we praise the Lord, saints? Hallelujah. Shall we praise the Lord another time? Are you glad to be in the house of the Lord today? I know that I am very glad to be in his presence. And we know that in his presence there is fullness of joy, and at his right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Hallelujah. First of all, I must greet our pastor, Lady Maureen, assistant pastor, evangelists, missionaries, saints, young people, everybody online, Zoom world. I greet you. Hello, good morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. And children, I greet you also in the mighty name of Jesus. We can't forget our children because they are precious in His sight. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You know, I was just listening to our pastor. You know, the Savior is coming. Regardless of whatever is going on in the world, we need to keep our eyes stayed on Him. We need to be in tune with Him through the Holy Spirit, which feeds our lives, which feeds our souls. And so many times, you know, there are viruses that want to come in and infiltrate and take over. But, you know, when we read the Word, which is our food, our daily bread, then we cannot go wrong. Praise the Lord. We cannot go wrong. Praise God. And, you know, I was just thinking, we've had a beautiful week, have we not? The sun was shining. We witnessed a wedding from this house. Praise the Lord. Bronte and Josh, what a beautiful day it actually was. It was so precious. It made me cry. Praise God. And also there was an anniversary. Pat and Fred, praise the Lord, who celebrated 32 years. You know, what a blessing. It has been a wonderful week. The sun has been shining and it's just been good. You know, on reflection, this time last year, yesterday, we would have buried our mom. A year has gone. But you know what? We give God thanks because I know where she is. And I have to get there. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I greet our mothers who are always in the house. God bless you, moms. You know, giving God thanks for you all. And upon that note, we're just going to have some praise and worship time. A time where you can give your sacrifice unto the Lord. Where you can, you know, if you are in a relationship with somebody, you want to get into a place where you can just offer up that praise and the ambience just comes and just sits among us. So that is what we want today. As we come to lift up the name of Jesus, to hear what the Lord would have us to hear. Because sometimes when we hear things, it's not the right things. We see things which is not the right things because the system is trying to condition us into a particular way. But the scripture said we should not be conformed to this world. But by the renewing of our mind, which is the daily word of God, hallelujah, that we're going to make it in this kingdom, in this world, to see the kingdom. Hallelujah. The praise and worship team, if you would come now, in Jesus' name.
Who is like the Lord? Nobody. Nobody is like our Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
Your presence is heaven to me. future days to come. Your presence is heaven to me. Your
Hallelujah. Your presence is heaven to me.
Hallelujah.
Can we just give the Lord
Hallelujah.
A praise?
Oh God.
Can we just stand and give the Lord a praise? Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I get the chance to praise him, I'm going to praise him. I'm going to worship him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because he's coming soon. Hallelujah. He's coming soon. Praise God. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. At this time, we're going to have a word of encouragement from Melinda Williams by video. Thank you.
Greetings, church, in the mighty name of Jesus. Nice to see you all, even though I'm not there with you. I'm with you in the spirit. I just want to give an encouragement to everyone who's listening. I don't know what it's been like for you recently or the past year or the past few months, but I'm sure it's been a storm. It's been a rough time for many. People don't know what's going on. They don't know what to listen to, what to believe, because so much information is flying around. And I just want to encourage you that God wants us to hear what he's saying. If you read the book of Job, it says that God spoke to Job in chapter 38 of Job, verse 1, that God spoke to Job in the midst of a whirlwind. So we may be going through a storm right now. This COVID-19 has come as a massive storm, a whirlwind. It's brought panic, and people are really panicking and don't know what to believe and what to listen to. But God does speak to us in the midst of a storm, whether you're going through personal issues, personal storm, God is speaking, and it's the best time to hear him. Sometimes the storm comes and God gets our attention. So I just want to encourage you that if you're going through anything, now's your time to turn your attention to God and to hear what he's saying. What's also been on my heart for the past few months is deception. I keep hearing over and over, do not let yourself be deceived. And when I was looking at Matthew 24:4, it says here, and Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceives you. So no one can deceive us. We have to let ourselves get deceived. And the word deceive means to be seduced, seduce people into rebellion, lead them astray, lead them down a wrong path, to cause to wander, to just go astray. And with so many things being flown around, so many things being said across social media, people being in a panic across the whole entire globe and releasing fear, people are going to be confused, and we're not meant to be confused. We're children of God. And our Bible says that God is not a God of confusion, and neither should his children be, because we're made in his image. So I just want you to be encouraged that you need to take firm and stand still on the word of God in your faith that you've had. And if your faith is being shaken right now, now's the time to get down on our knees, to pray. When we change our position and when we start to seek him, we start to hear differently and we actually start to hear him. Just really hold on to what you know God has shown you in your own life, who he's proved to be in your own life, because that's the biggest, most encouragement that each one of us need right now. No matter what we're hearing and what we're seeing, go to God, go to the Father. He shows us the end before the beginning. So people of God, hold on. Take heed to what God has told you. Take heed to what the word of God says that's going to happen in the end times, in the last days. Let the word of God be your media. Let it be your newspaper. Let it be your update. Let it be what you go to find out what's happening, because God is the source of all things seen and unseen. And I just want to encourage you to hold on, stay true to who you are in God, and be encouraged until we see each other again. God bless you and have a good day. Take care.
Man, isn't our God faithful? He is so faithful. And we continue to pray for the Thompson family. And, you know, yes, God is just, he's just amazing. He's absolutely amazing. And, you know, the prayers of the righteous, it does avail it much. Praise God. And he does hear and he does answer. Praise the Lord. And our sister Maisie, she would like to come now and pray. Again, we pray for the correct climate, the youth, fear, leaders, the church, souls, family, community, mental health, and so on. Knife crime, our sister Maisie now in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, ha koroma, hallelujah. God, we thank you, hallelujah. We lift you up, Lord. We magnify your name. God, thou art great, hallelujah, and worthy to be praised, hallelujah. Before anything else, God, it was you, God, hallelujah. You commanded this whole world into being, Lord, hallelujah. God, we lift you up. Oh, hallelujah, we exalt you. Oh, God, we thank you for another day. A day, Lord God, that you have made, Lord. We will rejoice and be glad in this day. Hallelujah. Oh, God, my Savior. Oh, God, even in this current climate, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, this worldwide pandemic, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, the world is in fear, Lord Jesus. But, God, our trust is in you, Lord God. Our hope is in you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, God, you are the remedy. You are the solution, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, my Savior. Yes, Lord, we do give thanks for the medics and the scientists, Lord God. But, God, it's you that's given them wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, Lord God. Without you, they are nothing, Lord Jesus. But overall, Lord God, our trust is in you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, God, my Savior. God, you said in your word, Lord, that if we just humble ourselves and pray, Lord God, then God, you would hear from heaven and you will heal our land. God, hallelujah, we're looking forward, Lord Jesus, hallelujah, to worship again as we used to, Lord Jesus, hallelujah. God, there is a reason, Lord God, for this season, Lord God. Oh God, souls will be drawn unto you, Lord Jesus. Oh God, it's given us time to stop and think, Lord God. Oh God, my Savior, you are in control, Lord God. Hallelujah. God, we thank you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for your people, Lord God. Remember the youth at this time, Lord Jesus. A strange time, Lord God, to be young, Lord God, and locked in, shut in, oh God, and not sure, Lord God, how long you can remain away from restrictions, Lord God. Remember them, Lord God, at home, Lord God, with their parents, Lord God, and loved ones. Remember them at school, Lord God. Be with them, Lord God, hallelujah. Remember them, Lord God, in the colleges and universities. God, help them be a light to others, Lord God, hallelujah. Oh God, remember every one of us, Lord God, in this place today, Lord God. And God, if we're watching, Lord God, via Zoom or watching later, Lord God, via the broadcast, God, I pray that you speak through us, Lord God. You speak to us, Lord Jesus. Oh God, my Savior, if it's even one word, one song, hallelujah. Remember the sick, Lord Jesus. God, I pray you just lay your healing hand, Lord God. Oh God, you're the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. Your power has not changed, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you for Sister Rihanna, Lord God. We didn't expect anything less. Hallelujah. God, we're praying with expectation. We're believing with expectation, Lord God. Hallelujah. God, my Savior, you still work miracles, Lord God. So many of us, Lord God, can give testimony, Lord God. Oh, God, of your great works, Lord God. You're a healer, Lord God. You're a provider, Lord Jesus. You're a deliverer, Lord God. You're a way maker, Lord Jesus. Above all, Lord Jesus, my Savior, you're a miracle worker. You still work miracles, Lord God. Oh God, whatever our situations are, Lord God, of problems at work, issues at home, whatever they may be, help us just to trust you, Lord God. Help us just to believe your word, Lord God. You are able, Lord God, to do exceedingly above everything that we can ask or think. You are able, Lord God. God, as we go into the furtherance of this service, Lord God, God, I pray, Lord God, that you be with us, Lord God. Continue to be with us, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Surround us, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Help us to worship you in spirit and in truth. And God, the unsaved world, Lord God, those, Lord God, that are looking to you, Lord God, reveal yourself to them, Lord God. If it's even one word, speak to them, Lord God. Have your mercy. Have your own way, Lord God. In your name, Jesus, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Let's bless the Lord, everyone. As mentioned, our scripture reading from 1 Corinthians 2, from verses 1 to 16. And I'll read all the verses, and then we can read the last verse together. And I, brethren, when I came to you, came not with excellency of speech or of wisdom, declaring unto you the testimony of God, for I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ and him crucified. And I was with you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. And my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power. That your faith should not stand in wisdom of men, but in the power of God. Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princes of this world that come to naught. But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory, which none of the princes of this world knew. For had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, I have not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the hearts of men the things which God hath prepared for them that love him. But God hath revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of a man which is in him? Even so, the things of God knoweth no man but the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. Which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. But he that is spiritual judgeth all things, yet he himself is judged of no man. Verse 16 and last, and we read together. For who hath known the mind of the Lord, that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. The Lord's words are already blessed. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The word is truly blessed. Thank you, Brother Irvin, for reading the word of God. And now we have come to a time of the word. Praise the Lord. And this is where we have to turn up our antennas. Amen. And tune in. Try and tune in. Get your dial. Get, you know, tune it in properly. Amen. And this is going to be by our one and only Minister Fred Kerr. But before he comes, you know how I like singing. This song has just been laid on my heart. I'm just going to sing it one time if I can. It's really no goodness of my own,
no, but it's by the grace of God that we've been kept all this time, and we still have the mind to go on. Oh. It's really no goodness of my own,
no,
no goodness of our own, but it's by the grace of God. Amen. Amen. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. If it wasn't for the grace of God, we wouldn't be here this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Somebody shout a praise in the house today. Somebody lift their hands and shout a praise in the house this morning. Come on, we're too quiet. God has been too good to us for us to be quiet. We need to lift him up and give him praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for Sister Rihanna. Let's give God thanks for Sister Rihanna. Let's give God thanks for what he has done in our lives. Hallelujah. We have so much to give God thanks for. Amen. Woke us up this morning. Hallelujah. Woke us up this morning. Brought us into his house. Hallelujah. If there's anything we need to be grateful for, it's for the fact that we are alive and we are well. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise God and we celebrate him this morning. And we thank him for what he has done and for what he's going to do. We bless his name this morning and we honor him. And to our worthy pastor and his lovely wife, and to our sister, Pastor David Copeland, and his lovely wife, to my wife, who is the joy of my life and the strength of my life. Without her, I'm nothing. I give God thanks for her. And I also just wanted to just say thank you all for your prayers and your support, and for even making the sacrifices to come down to my daughter's wedding. I pray, God, that you will pray them up. Keep them in their prayers, because they have ventured into a new chapter of their lives. Amen. And they need God, and they need the prayers of the saints. Amen. Because we understand we can't make it without our God. Amen. We are nothing without God. We can achieve everything that we want to achieve, but we're nothing without God. Amen. So keep them in your prayers, and I thank you on behalf of them. They will probably come and say their own thank yous, but I just want to say a personal thank you to all my brethren, all my brothers, my sisters, my pastor, everybody, for celebrating the wedding of my daughter. Amen. Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Very quickly, I haven't got long, but I've just obviously come today just to encourage your hearts. Encourage your hearts. I've just come to just build up your faith. That's the duty of every leader, every pastor, is to build up the saints in your most holy faith. Strengthen you in what you believe. Amen? Amen? That's the responsibility of the pastors and the leaders and the teachers. Because we must understand, and we must all understand, that where your treasure is, as I've said before, that's where your heart is going to be. Amen? What you love is what you're going to chase after. We must set our affections upon things above, not on things on this earth. Set your affections upon things above. The Bible says that we must lay our treasures in, not upon this earth, but we must lay our treasures in earth, where no moth, no rust, no corrupt, and most importantly, no thief can break in and steal. Hallelujah. Lay your treasures up in heaven. Amen. 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 And that's the old duty of leadership, is to encourage the brethren to do that. Amen. Amen. We are called to build you up in your faith, what you think, what you believe. It is our duty to encourage you to have the mind of Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Understanding the fact that you are an overcomer. Understanding that you are more than a conqueror through Jesus Christ who loves us. Amen. Amen. And very quickly, I just want you to turn to your neighbor and say, as my assignment is today, it is time to make a difference. Turn to your neighbor and say, it is time to make a difference. Turn to another neighbor and say to them, it is time for us to make a difference. Amen. It is time for us to make a difference. Amen. High time, high time. We have slumbered and we have slept, but it's high time. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We're approaching the bride of Christ is coming. High time for us to make a change. High time for us to make a difference. Amen. And we have read from 1 Corinthians chapter 2. And I'm just going to read just a couple of scriptures very quickly. Then I'm going to pray, and then we'll go straight into what the Lord has laid on my heart for you today. Amen. And verse 1, it says, and I, brethren, when I came to you, came not with excellency of speech or of wisdom, declaring unto you the testimonies of God. For I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ and him crucified. Verse 4, and my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of men's wisdom. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. But in the demonstration of the Spirit and power of God. Let's praise the name of the Lord. Verse 10. But God hath revealed unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of the man which is in him? Even so the things of God knoweth no man but the Spirit of God. Now we have not received the spirit of the world, but we have received that which is the Spirit which is of God, that we may know the things that are freely given to us. Amen? Amen? Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus right now, Lord, I ask you, O God, to help me right now. I need you to speak through me, Lord Jesus. I need you to speak a word that will lift up your people, that will change their minds, that will help them in their destiny, help them in the pursuit of things that you have called them to do. Father, bless this word. Bless me now as I give you glory and give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Let's bless the name of the Lord, everyone. It's time to make a difference. It's time to make a difference. Your life, my life, is worth nothing unless I or we have finished the work that has been assigned to us. Let me say that again. Our life is worth nothing unless we have finished the work that has been assigned to us by the Lord Jesus Christ. So whatever you do in this life and achieve in this life, unless you understand that your life belongs to God and that you are assigned and destined to work for him, it means nothing. It means nothing. Mark declares in 8 and verse 36 through to verse 37, he says, "For what profit a man if he gains the old world and loses his soul? What can a man give in exchange for his soul?" People are chasing after riches and wealth. People are chasing after fame and fortune. But Mark, the Bible declares and tells us and reminds us, what does it profit us? What does it profit us to gain the world and everything that's in there? We must understand that to miss our assignment, to miss our purpose, and to miss our destiny in this life is to miss out on what God and the reason why God has put us on the earth. Let me say that again. To miss out on our assignment and our purpose and destiny in this life is to miss out on why the reason God has placed us on this earth. We are here by design. Brother David Copeland mentioned that. We are here by purpose or for a purpose. Amen? Amen? We're here by design. It's not just a coincidence. It's not an accident. We're here by design, by God's ordained destination. Amen? Amen? And while we are here, we have to understand that whatever we do, it's working for our good. Amen? Romans declares and says, "And we know that all things work together for good to them that love the Lord and to them that are called according to his purpose." Hallelujah, hallelujah. So whether it's good, whether it's bad, or whether it's indifferent, everything works out for a good. Why? Because you are called. You are called, and you are called for his purpose. Amen? We have an assignment on our lives. We have a job to be done, a job to do, and time is running out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. You have to understand, people of God, brothers and sisters, that you are gifted. You are gifted. You are gifted. And you are called by God. And we have to take it very seriously. We have to take it seriously. Amen? Because we have to give an account. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Hallelujah. We have to give an account of the deeds we've done in our body, what we've done with this ministry and the gifting that he's given us. We have to give an account. Because we are gifted by design and by purpose. And God has called us. So we have to take our election and our calling sure and serious. Hallelujah. Do you believe that? Hallelujah. We've got to take it serious. And the question is not what we're running away from, but it's more so what we're moving towards. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We have to understand that we are here to make a difference. We are called to make a difference in our families, in our homes, in our facilities, in our school. Wherever we go, we are called to make a difference. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And to succeed, to be successful, we have to understand that we must know God's will, God's purpose, and we must concentrate on fulfilling that purpose. Hallelujah. And we must not allow anything to distract us from the call of the Lord on our lives. He has called all of us to do something. We all have a job to do in the church, outside the church. We all have a job to do. Amen. And we must take it serious. And to be successful, we must do what God has called us to do and concentrate fully on fulfilling the assignment. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Got to do it. I know we're human beings. I know we're governed by rules and regulations. I know that we need to look after our family and our friends, and we have to work and look after our children. I understand all of that. I know, and God knows too. But the assignment that He has given to us is greater than anything else that we can think of. Amen? Amen. And God must come first. Amen. God must come first. Amen? Amen? God must come first. Our purpose, not money, not talent, is the greatest asset that we can have. Our purpose in God. Not money, not talent, is the greatest asset that we can have. With a God-given purpose, it is the ultimate gold. The ultimate gold above everything you can think of. You want a great name, you want to be famous, you want to reach the skies and do great exploits. But the greatest thing and purpose is a God purpose-driven life. Hallelujah. 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 Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the Lord. And with our God-given purpose and assignment, we don't need to worry. We don't need to be afraid how we're going to do it, how it's going to come to pass. Because if God says you've got to do it, He will make the way for you to do it. He will bring provisions for you. He will bring resources for you and cause you to have the ability to bring it to pass. Because His word will not come back void to Him. And if He has destined you to be great, and you to be great, His word will not come back to Him void. You will be great. You will be anointed. You will be powerful. You will do great things in God. Amen? Greater works than this, than what He has done, we will do. Amen? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We can do all things. And we have to understand that, as the scripture reminds us, that we must seek Him first, always. Amen. Seek the kingdom. Seek His righteousness. And all other things will be added unto us. So we don't worry, we don't fear what's going on around us, because we have a God that will make provisions for His people. Amen? Amen. And the philosopher and motivational speaker, Charles Garfield, said that peak performers are people who are committed to a compelling mission. And it's very clear that they care deeply about what they do and their efforts and energies and enthusiasms. And this is traceable back to that particular mission. What he was saying was that, in other words, is that people who have a mission will go out 100% to pursue that mission. They are passionate for that mission, okay? Nothing will stop them. No doubters will stop them. They will work and bring it to pass. What we have to understand, brothers and sisters, is that we are here on the earth, and God has called us, the church, not just to show off our skills biblically, our teaching, our preaching, our singing. We are the best church, we're the biggest church. That's not what the mission of what God has called us for. That is not us making a difference. Hallelujah. We must be passionate for the things of God. Hallelujah. And He has called us, all of us, to make a difference. He has called us, and He's not only just called us, but He has placed His Spirit upon us. Hallelujah. He has placed His Holy Spirit upon us. And Luke reminds us of what our mission and our assignment is. In Luke 4, verse 18, it says that our mission is to preach the gospel. Our mission is to heal the brokenhearted. Glory to God. Our mission is to preach deliverance to the captive. People that are in prison, physically, mentally, spiritually, we are to preach deliverance to them. Our mission. Recovering the sight of them that are blind. Again, spiritual blindness. Again, physical blindness. The Church of Jesus Christ, that is our mission. Amen. Set at liberty them that are bruised. Bruised. What a time we're living in. Domestic violence, rape, abuse. We, the people of God, we have the word that will set them free. Amen. We have the word of God that will set them free. We have to preach that 2021 is the year to accept Jesus Christ. If there's any time that we need to accept Jesus Christ in our lives, it's 2021. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That is the mission of each and every one of us, church collectively, corporately. That is what we are called to make a difference concerning. Amen? So you see how our mission is great. You see how it's great? It's great. We have a lot to do. There's a lot to be done. We have but a short time to do it within. Hallelujah. As you says, Pastor, God is coming soon. We see the signs. We see everything happening around us. We have a short time to make a difference. Bless the name of the Lord. We have to make a difference. And very quickly, we've seen through history, we've seen how we've had great influential men, great leaders, great people in the history books that have made a difference in the world and in the society that we live in. We've seen them, great men. And not only that, but one of the things that the world is so concerned about in this time is obviously education, money, and wisdom. That's the number one thing that everybody strives for in this world. That's what everybody wants to go for. Education, money, wisdom. But we've got, in history, we've got great people that have made a difference. That have made a difference. Whether saved or unsaved, they've made a difference. Amen? We have people like Socrates. We have people like Isaac Newton. We have people like Charles Darwin, even though we don't believe him. But William Shakespeare, just to name a few, who have made a difference in their time and in their season and in their generation. They have all been influential in change and making a difference. But there's one person that I want to quote from. Do you remember Mozart? Wolfgang Mozart? He was a prolific composer of classical music. And he quoted something, and I just want to just quote it for you. And he says, "Music is my life, and my life is music. And anyone who does not understand this is not worthy of God." This is Mozart. Mozart was a Roman Catholic Christian, okay? And he believed God all of his life. And he understood that if it hadn't been for God in his music, he wouldn't be what he is today. He's known all over the world for his music and his composites. And he reminds us that once we have God in our lives, we can make a difference. Amen. And some of them obviously rejected the truth and didn't wholeheartedly find the truth. They failed to open themselves up to the truth. and to discover that God's given assignment and purposes. But they made a change, but they still made a difference in their circumstances. Remember, Martin Luther was the main person that started the Protestant reform, which Thomas Jefferson, Abraham Lincoln, Rosa Parks, Martin Luther King, just a few people that made a difference in their season, in their generation, and in their time. Amen? They were influential, and they made a difference. But we have one who we call to be the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world. We have one that has no equal. Hallelujah. We have one that has no equal. He is the undisputed champion of the world. There is no one like him. There's no one after him. There's no one greater than him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And his name is Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He stands out from the crowd. Glory to God. Glory to God. He's head and shoulders above every principalities and powers. Hallelujah. And people and tongue. He stands head and shoulders above them all. And the most important thing, he's the only one that is still alive today. Glory to God. Somebody should praise the name of the Lord for the fact that our God, that Jesus Christ is alive today, alive in our hearts, alive in our souls, alive in our circumstances, alive and keeping us alive. Amen. Jesus Christ is the champion of the world. Amen. He is alive. He rose from the grave. Was seen of over 500 people. What he has done for the world in making a difference, nobody else has done it. Hallelujah. Nobody else could. Hallelujah. He has given to the world, not just the church, but to the world, the greatest gift that we could ever have. The greatest opportunity that we can ever have. Amen. We have access and right now to God through Jesus Christ. We were strangers far from the commonwealth of Israel, but Jesus Christ has made the way open that you and I can reach God. Amen. Hallelujah. It's the greatest gift you can give to anybody. It's the greatest gift you can give to anybody. Amen. His contribution to the world is life-changing. Bless the name of the Lord. It's life-changing. You come in contact with Jesus, you will never be the same again. I guarantee you, one encounter with Jesus, you will never be the same again. Amen? Amen. Amen. And he commands each and every one of us. So we have received him. Hallelujah. We must give freely to others. Amen. It's time to make a difference. So we have received Christ. We are to share Christ to the world. Amen? Amen? We have to tell him of this wonderful love. Tell them of his wonderful grace. Tell him of his amazing grace. Hallelujah. Tell him how he's changed our life. Hallelujah. Jesus has made the difference. And we should give him a praise. We should raise our hands. We should open up our mouths and exalt the name of Jesus. Bethel Lighthouse Christian Center. It is time to make a difference. Amen. It is time where we have to be ministering on a different level. Did you hear that? Amen. Bethel Lighthouse Christian Center. The world is looking to us. Everyone's looking to us. It's time that we make a difference. It's time that we start to minister on a different level. It is time for us to demonstrate on a different level, on another level. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's time for us to demonstrate the power of God. Not saying that we didn't have it before, because I saw a glimpse of it in my mother's era, in Sister Clark's era, in Brother Lewis and Mother Lucy's era, I saw a glimpse of the power of God. Were you there? Were any of you there? Did you glimpse the power and anointing? When I was not part of this church and I was just visiting with Irving, I used to go to Church of God, and you guys used to worship over in Ruku Road, across the road from where the Church of God used to have their meeting. And I used to leave my dry service and go over to Ruku Road. And I went over there, and the power and the anointing in that place, it moved me to the fact that I got saved under that anointing, under that power. It moved me. So I have seen a glimpse of it. And I've seen a glimpse of it when we had the revival. Do you remember the revival? Glory to God. Do you remember, Irv? How God moved and the power of God came down? God is saying it's time for us to get back to that place. It is time for us to get back to that anointing. It's time for us to get back to that place of power. Hallelujah and anointing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Janet, we have to ignite. Neil, we have to light the candles. We have to do it. We have to do it. Neil, we've got to ignite. Janet, we have to ignite. Neil, we have to light the candles of our communities and our homes. We've got to do it. We've got to get back to that place where the Church of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, makes a difference. Bless the name. And I need every one of us to participate. It's not just the pastor. It's just not just the assistant pastor. I need every one of us to participate in the great move of God. Because you have to understand that our God is coming back for a glorious church. A church that is without spot and without wrinkle. He's coming back for a powerful church. Hallelujah. He's not coming for a weak, insignificant church. He's coming for a church that will stand up for the cause. A church that will proclaim his name in all the earth. A church that is proud and strong and mighty and confident in the God that they serve. That's the church that our God is coming back for. That's what he wants us to do today, church. Bethel, Lighthouse, we've got to change. We've got to make a difference. Glory to his name. We've got to do it. We've got to do it. And Paul in Corinthians 1 says to us and reminded us that it's not about articulation. It's not about excellence of speech. It's not about wisdom. It's not about that. It's not about education, knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Even though I know those things are very important and needed. But he says it's not about that. Hallelujah. It's not about that. Hallelujah. We understand and we know that wisdom, to have wisdom, we know that we have to depart from evil. To have wisdom, we know that we have to respect one another. Wisdom, we know that. To have knowledge, we know that we have to be reading the word of the Lord. To have knowledge, we know that we have to have a relationship with God. To have knowledge, we know that we have to know who we serve and who we worship. Hallelujah. And to have understanding, we know that God is to be adored. To have understanding, we know that God is to be worshipped. To have understanding, we know that God is to be praised. To have understanding, we know that God is to be lifted up. We know all that. We know all of that. But Paul is reminding us it's not about that. It's not about that. It's about declaring the testimonies of our God. Amen. 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 And we understand that we live in a era where our kids have come up and they have education. They have degrees. They have doctorates. They have masters. They probably tend to be a little bit smarter and clever than we are. We understand that, but we have to understand and remind them that it is the Spirit and the power of God that makes the difference in one's life. Amen? And we have to minister in that area. Amen? We have to minister in a different area. Amen? Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. If we operate under and in intelligence and in wisdom, we will not be able to compete. We will not be able to compete because there is always somebody clever than we are. There will always be somebody smarter than we are. Hallelujah. there will be somebody smaller. So we can't compete in that area. Our level of ministry is not in the intellect. It's not in the mind. It's not in that area. Bless the name of the Lord. Let alone able to save them. But the Bible says, if the princes of the world knew, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. They were operating through their wisdom and intellect. Hallelujah. But we, the children and the people of God, we operate in a different level of ministry. Amen? 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 Amen. And we understand that the gospel is it to them out in the world because of their mind. It's they're lost because they're operating in their senses. So the Bible says that the gospel to them is lost. They're lost and it's hid because they're operating in their mind. In their mind. But the people of God, we have to minister differently. Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. Our job. And verse 2 says, for I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ and him crucified. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ and him crucified. Our job, church, brethren, saints, brothers and sisters, family and friends, our job is to point people to Christ. Amen. That's our job. Our job. No, we know nothing other but Jesus Christ. That's what Paul was saying right here. I know anything. I just want to point them to Christ. We just need to point them to Christ. We have come. We must come to the front, people of God. We must stand and come to the front and declare to the world that Jesus is the answer. Amen. We have to come to the front, shout it aloud, and say that Jesus is the balm, the healing balm for the nation. We have to shout it. Too long we have been silenced and quiet. It is now time, Bethel Lighthouse Christian Center, for us to make a difference. And Jesus gave us specific instructions to do that. And he said that we must go into all the world and preach the gospel. Amen? We've got to do it. We've got to do it. We've got to preach it to every creature. And I know that some of us may be doing it, but we need to do it on a corporate level, on a grander scale. Hallelujah. So that the world will see us. This is the season and the time for the church to operate on a greater scale, to operate on a greater dimension. Glory to God. To operate on another level. It is time for us to raise the game. Raise the game. Stop using enticing words. We have great speakers. We have great preachers. It's time for us to stop using what we have learned through Bible college, Bible school, teaching, enticing words, tickling words that will soothe and comfort people. We have to get back to how our mothers and fathers used to preach it and be truth, tell the truth. Glory to God. Glory to God. Stop the enticing words, church. Stop the church terminology. Stop the church lingo. Stop it. That's what Paul was saying here. But we must come in demonstration of the Spirit and power of God. Hallelujah. 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 And our ministry, I'm closing. Our ministry, as I said, it's time for us to make a difference. Our ministry is on a different level. The ministry that we need to understand and to operate in is where we minister to spirit to spirit. Amen. That's how we minister. We minister to spirit to spirit. Hallelujah. And we see all through the Bible, we see Jesus set the example. The Bible says that Jesus knew their thoughts. And then we see Paul and the apostles coming up and rebuking that lady with divination and speaking to the spirit of the woman. So we, our ministry and our calling is to spirit. So when we are talking to somebody, the spirit of discernment that we have inside of us, because God has given all of us the spirit of discernment. Whether you want to believe it or not, he has given you something inside of you that you can detect evil from afar off before they even come in your vicinity. We have an antenna that can detect. It's called the Spirit of God. And Jesus showed us and demonstrated that to us time and time again. When he dealt with people, he never dealt with them according to what he saw. He dealt with what he saw in the heart. In the heart. And that's how we have to minister. We have to minister from that perspective. We have to minister from that perspective. The God of this universe is expecting us to do that. First and foremost, our difference comes through the demonstration of the Spirit and the power of God. We make a difference through the Spirit and through the power of God. That's the only way we can make a difference. Self will fail. When we operate in the Spirit to Spirit, that's what happens. And we can tell and discern the thoughts and interests of the heart of the people. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has he entered into the hearts of men, the things that God has prepared for them that love him. Amen? Amen. It's time to make a difference. And the only way we can make a difference is when we operate in the Spirit of God. When we witness Spirit to Spirit, then God will get the glory and God will be lifted up. Be blessed. It's time to make a difference. Amen.
Shall we praise the Lord? We're just going to praise the Lord, saints. Giving the Lord God thanks for this wonderful service. And I trust that you all have been blessed. And you can all take home something to keep you for the week. And we have come to the end of the service. And I would just like to wish you for this week a blessing, that everything that you've requested from the Lord, that it will come to fruition, and that you will lack nothing for this week and the future, because we serve a mighty God. Hallelujah. So we're just going to stand, and I'll just close in prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for this privilege. We thank you for this opportunity to find ourselves in your house, to worship you, to lift up your name, to give you, Lord God, a praise, a sacrifice. I pray that, Lord God, my Savior, it went up before you as a sweet-smelling savor, Lord, and that you will receive it, Lord God, from every heart, and that the hearts, Lord God, of your people were at the right place to receive their blessings, Lord God, to receive whatever they needed, Lord God, my Savior, to take them through this week. Father, I'm asking you to protect, Lord God, my Savior, as we leave from this here. Lord God, go before us. Lord God, my Savior, make a way out of no way. So many people, Lord God, my Savior, do not know where their next morsel of meal is coming from. But Lord God, you said we should not worry about that, because Lord God, my Savior, our trust is in you, Lord God. And you know what we need more than we need ourselves, Lord Jesus. So we just put our lives into your hand. Every young person, every child, every mother, every father, every sister, every brother, every auntie, every uncle. Father God, we just pray, Lord God, that you'll be with us through this week, Lord God. Shine upon us, Lord God, my Savior, and let your will, Lord God, be done in our lives today, Lord God. We say thank you in advance for everything. Lord God, my Savior, we can never thank you enough, Lord God. We can never give you enough glory and praise, Lord Jesus. But we just say thank you for now, Lord God. As Lord God, we say thank you again. And Lord God, we go in peace now in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, our Lord and our Redeemer. And our Redeemer. Amen. Praise God. You are free to go. God bless you all.
We would like to take this opportunity to invite you to sow a seed in the ministry here at Bethel Lighthouse. The Bible tells us that our reward for giving comes from God, and we welcome your gift to support our many ministries. You can give by following the details on the screen or by clicking the giving link in the description box. God bless you.
Say